Hey, hey YouTube, it's Miss T. Today I just wanted to come to you all and share with you how I placed my tracks for a U-part wig. I've been making U-part wigs for quite some time, even before they became popular here on YouTube. I think I made my first U-part wig in like 2008 before I even started uploading videos to YouTube. I've seen a lot of people do their track placement for a U-part wig, and then they'll, after they've done the wig, and say that it was a fail. And usually they don't know that their cap either is too big or too small because of the way that they are placing their tracks. It's very important when you do a U-part wig to know the track placement. A lot of people are simply doing it the way that you would do a sew-in, which is not the wrong way. I'm not saying that they're doing it wrong. What I'm saying is I don't place my tracks the way that everybody else is placing their tracks, simply because I've learned that over the years, like I said, I did my first one in 2008. It wasn't a total fail, but the cap was entirely too big, and then I did it again and the cap was entirely too small, and I've just kind of mastered how to place the tracks for the U-part to fit your head the perfect way. And that does exclude making it on your head. That's the only other way that you will get a U-part to fit your head the correct way. So I'm gonna get everything set up and going to just basically explain what I use, why I use it, and how I place the tracks, and then I'll come back and actually show you me placing the tracks on the cap that I use. So I'll be right back. Okay, now I want to show you all what tools I use and explain to you all why I use the things that I use to make my U-part wig. As you can see, I have a styrofoam head here with a weaving cap on it. I actually don't use the styrofoam head. I use a mannequin head, but I did want to use the styrofoam head so that you can see what I'll be doing when I go into the explanation of me doing my track placement. And I'm actually going to use the mannequin head to do the U-part wig, but I am going to at first explain using the styrofoam head. I use a mannequin head, which I have here. I use a mannequin head. I use the mannequin head because the mannequin has hair. And it just gives me a more realistic U-part versus using a styrofoam head. Because this doesn't have hair, the cap doesn't fit the head properly as it would if you use a mannequin with hair. And that's the only reason I do use the mannequin head. These are the caps that I use. I use these because they're stretchy. You get a really good stretch with it. So, as far as your cap being too small, you shouldn't have a problem with that. I also use them because they contain the adjustable straps, as well as it's a net. I don't use the dome caps because they're made of cotton, and cotton absorbs moisture, which when you're using the dome cap, that's exactly what's going on with your hair. That dome cap is basically just sucking up all the natural oils in your hair and can cause your hair to be dry. So that's the only reason that I don't use the dome caps for me. If that's what you choose to use, to each his own. That's the reason I don't use the dome cap. I also use these nets sometimes, and these are actually my favorite. You get a whole lot of stretch with this one. And I also like it because It contains the comb, and it also has the adjustable straps. This is by this company. If I have to make a U-part on a styrofoam head, what I usually do is take a wig and place it on here. But I usually just go ahead and use my mannequin head. I do want to explain to you all how I place my tracks. Because as I stated before, I do not place my tracks the way that everybody else places their tracks. What I do is, you know, a lot of people cut their flaps off that are on these necks. A lot of people cut their flaps off up to their first little band that you will see on them. Well, I don't. What I actually do is sew my first track right underneath the band, and the reason that I do that is because it does secure the nape area of the U-part wig. Then what I do after I've sewn that first track up under that band, what I do is fold the track and sew it right above the band, and that secures that area. Then I continue to go from ear to ear until the occipital bone, which is the area in the back of your head where it curves. When I get there, what I do is take and curve the tracks the same way as though you're doing a sew-in. Curve the tracks up from ear to ear until I get to about here. You can see where this little area is, this little piece of netting, and that would typically be right above your ear if this was on your head. So when I get here to the top of my ear, or to the top of the ear on the styrofoam head or the mannequin's head, what I do is start to do the tracks in a arch till I get to right at the crown of the head. And when I get to the crown of the head, I'll go back to the U part till I get to where I want it to form my U part. I'm going to explain that one more time, and I'm going to take it off of this mannequin stand because it's squeaking. So, very first thing I do is sew my first track underneath this band. Fold the track, sew right above the band. That secures my nape area. I do that from ear to ear till I get to where the occipital bone is. And then I take and I start to curve the tracks. I do not sew on this band because this is where your adjustable straps are. So I don't sew on that band, but I do sew right above it. So when I get to the occipital bone, that's going to stop on the side. That will stop right about there. Then I'll start to sew the tracks, like I said, curving them. I'll do that curve till I get right at the top of the ear. Once I get to the top of the ear, I take the tracks and I sew them in an arch till I get to the crown of the head. When I get to the crown of the head, I go back to sewing in the U shape until you get to the amount of space that you want to leave out. I also wanted to talk to you all about stitching for your U part. I've done two different stitches here, and they're not necessarily the way that I would stitch these tracks on. It's just the stitching to give you an idea of the spaces that should be used for your stitching when you do your U parts, when you sew your tracks on. I would say this is a typical stitching of what you would use for your sew-ins. All I've done is just take and simply just put the needle around just to create some kind of stitching so that you can see. But as you can see, these are like really, really close together, really tight stitching. This is not a stitching that you want to use for your U-part because your tracks will not have room to give. Meaning that your tracks will not have room to stretch and move when you place your U-part cap on your head. You want to use a stitching that is kind of wider so that your tracks will have room to move and they won't be so snug and so tight when you do place your U-part on your head. This was a lesson that I had to learn because, of course, with me specializing in healthy sew-ins, it was hard for me to space my stitching out because I always use a small stitching for my sew-ins. So that's basically all I wanted to let you know, is that your stitching does make a difference in the way that your cap will fit. You want to use a stitching that is wider versus a stitching that is smaller. I'm going to stretch the cap so that you can see the difference. You see how much more the top stitching stretches when I pull the cap and stretch the cap, and the smaller stitching doesn't stretch as much. So you do want to use a stitching that is wider versus a stitching that is smaller. I'm going to go on to the making of the U-part so that you all can get that. But I did just want to come to you all and basically just kind of give you a idea of why your cap either may be too big or too small. And I'll come back and show you all what I'm doing and explain to you all what I'm doing as I'm doing it.